Here are some slides on Fourier and partial differential equations. In all of the following, always remember that sine of n of x is an eigenfunction of the d square operator with eigenvalue minus n.
We work in the linear space x of all piecewise smooth 2π periodic functions. Indeed, we can add functions in x, scale functions in x, and have the zero function in x.
An inner product in X is the integral of the product of the two functions. This allows us to compute lengths, angles or projections. As a geometric problem, let's find the angle between the two functions X and the sine of X. We use the familiar formula for the cosine of the angle. The inner product of the two functions is equal to 2. The length of the two functions can be computed too. From this we can get the cosine of the angle theta.
The functions cosine n of x, sine of n of x, as well as the constant function 1 over the square root of 2, form an orthonormal set in the linear space X. They have been chosen because they all are eigenfunctions.
The Fourier series writes a function as a sum of these basis functions. As in finite dimensions, the coefficients are given by the inner products of the function f, with the basis vectors.
The approximation works also in the case of functions which have discontinuities. If we truncate the Fourier series and sum a finite number of terms, we get to smooth approximation.
Functions which are symmetric with respect to the y-axis are called even. For such functions, only the cosine and constant part of the Fourier series matter. In this case, we can integrate from 0 to pi and multiply by 2.
If the graph of f is invariant under reflection at the origin, the function is called odd. For odd functions, only the sine series matters. Again, we can integrate from 0 to pi and multiply by 2.
Here is the first problem. Find the Fourier series of the function which is 2 on the interval from pi third to pi half and minus 2 from minus pi half to minus pi third. We first note that the function is odd. We only need to find the sine series. It is no problem to integrate. We can leave a generalization of Pythagoras tells us that the square of the length of the function is the sum of the squares of the Fourier coefficients. Unfortunately, little is known about Mark Antoine Parseval, who first found this cool formula.
Here is the prototype example. The function is f equal to x. The square of its length is 2/3. The square of the Fourier coefficient b of n is 4 over pi square n square. Parseval tells us now that the sum of the reciprocals of the squares is pi square over 6. This is the solution of the Basel problem. It is the value of the famous zeta function at the point s equal to 2.
Now, we look at partial differential equations, especially at the heat and the wave equation. In the heat case, we can give the initial temperature. In the wave case, we think of a string, which we either pluck or hit. When plucking, we prescribe the initial position. When hitting, the initial velocity.
For convenience, we always use a sine series. In all cases, we always look at the evolution on the interval from 0 to pi. If we continue as an odd function, we get the sine series. We do not mind if the function is not 0 at 0 or pi. The Fourier series will do fine in the interior of the interval.
In all cases, the initial situation is given by a sine series. Each of the sine modes is an eigenfunction of the d square operator, so that on the right-hand side we have lambda times the function. The corresponding ordinary differential equations are known. In the heat case we reduce to f prime equals lambda f, which has the solution e to the lambda t, which in the d square case is e to the minus n square t. In the wave equation, the equation f2 prime equals lambda f is the harmonic oscillator. It has the solution cos nt and sine nt. For the initial position we get cosine nt, and with initial velocity we get sine nt over n. You can check that if you take the derivative of the solution with respect to t and put t equal to 0, you get the initial
Again, we took the sine series to simplify things. The operator a on the right-hand side has the sin function as an eigenfunction, leading to either the exponential decay differential equation or to the harmonic oscillator. As we will see, the operator a does not have to be the d-square operator, it can be any function of the d-square operator. We just have to know the eigenvalues lambda and get the solution formula for the corresponding heat and wave equation.
Here is the first example. We want to solve the heat equation for the function f of x equal to x times pi minus x. We compute the Fourier coefficients b of n, then write down the solution. All the work which is needed is in the computation of the Fourier series.
In example 2, we solve the weight equation for which the initial string position is given by f x equal to x from 0 to pi over 2 and 0 else. Again, the work reduces to the computation of the Fourier coefficients. Note that in this case we form an integral from 0 to pi over 2 and ignore the integration from pi over 2 to pi since the function.
Here is an experiment with a string. If we start with a basic Eigen mode, the string will just oscillate forth and back. At every point we have a harmonic oscillator. The general motion is a superposition of all these motions of B.
In this example 3, we give the initial velocity. We again have to build the Fourier series and then add the factor sine of nt over n. This example computes the motion of the string if it has been hit by a hammer on the left-hand side of the string.
Unlike for continuous dynamical systems, we never have to worry about computing the Eigen functions. We always take sine n of x.
Here is the situation when we have a more general operator to the right. Just get the eigenvalues of this operator and use the same formulas as before. In the wave case, we have to take the square root of minus lambda. In the case when lambda was minus n square, this is equal to n.
In this example, the operator is d square minus d to the power 4 minus 3 times the identity. The initial heat is already given as a Fourier series. It has only one term. We can directly write down the solution. No work was needed here except computing the eigenvalues of the operator and noticing that sine of 4 of x is the Fourier mode to n.
Here is the wave case with the same initial condition. Again, any additional work would be reinventing the wheel. We can write down the solution minding that we have the initial position.
And finally, the same function but as an initial velocity, we have to remember to divide by the square root of minus the eigenvalue as a differentiation will cancel that and lead to the initial velocity at t equal to 0.
Thanks for listening. Before closing up, let's add a few slides about why Fourier theory and partial differential equations are so.
Fourier theory is used to compress pictures, movies or songs. There are various formats. The most popular are JPEG for pictures, MPEG for movies and MP3 for sound. The compression rate is spectacular.
An important application is in computer tomography or when analyzing material using diffraction. The mathematical problems reduce to a problem of inverting matrices or operators. Fourier theory allows to diagonalize these operators explicitly like in the case.
Here is the problem in a nutshell. Usually using resonance or absorption we know the average density of the tissue along some line. From these data we have to reconstruct the tissue density by using polar coordinates, making a Fourier expansion in the angular direction and a Taylor expansion in the radial direction we give an explicit inversion formula.
An unexpected application is in number theory, where Fourier theory is an integral part to get information about primes, the building blocks of the integers. Some call it the music of the primes. We have seen a glimpse of it as we could compute the value of the zeta function at some point using Parseval. The zeta function encodes the prime numbers. Still a lot of problems are in the dark, like the location of the roots of the zeta function. The Riemann hypothesis is the most important open problem.
The structure of the periodic system of elements in chemistry can be understood from a single operator, which is the Hamiltonian of the hydrogen atom. By understanding its eigenvalues and eigenfunctions, one can deduce the inner structure of the atoms. For each of the eigenvalues 1 over n square, there are a set of eigenfunctions. They are labeled by azimuthal.
One of the coolest applications of Fourier theory is fast multiplication of integers. The classical school multiplication uses n square steps if the numbers have n digits. This can be done faster by first producing functions from the numbers, then doing the Fourier decomposition of the product. Of course, there is overhead so that the method is only used for larger integers.
Finally, here are three pioneers. Fourier was inventing Fourier series to solve the Hund equation. The operator d square is also called the Laplace operator. Laplace was studying its properties also in higher dimensions. We also mentioned the D'Alembert, who gave solutions of the wave equation.
This is the end. The animation shows successive approximations of a function using finite sums.